Start. All of you ready with pen and paper? Okay. So here I am starting the quiz and 3, 2, 1, go. So the first question is on your screen. If you are not able to see the question, then I can show it on the tab as well. So just let me know. If x is the root of equation sine square x plus sine x minus 2 equals 0, then please read the question carefully. Read the question carefully. Again, I will keep on reiterating this because you will be trapped there. So questions have been set by me with some, things in mind, your vulnerability is mine in mind. So hence, take your time and solve. So in today's quiz or centermar, we'll have two types of questions. For the application of trigonometry questions, the time is 2 minutes, and you need to learn how to solve that question in within 2 minutes. We'll discuss that at length. Because in exams like NDSC, you are supposed to solve it like that only, or in fact within a minute. Okay, so hence we will. I have so the, this is the first quiz, so hence on trigonometric application, I have given you 2 minutes, but later on we'll reduce it. Okay, so we have some 20 more seconds and some around 15 people have not voted, I believe. There are 67, 68. How many are there? 70 around. Okay, so. Very good. So here is 3, 2, and 1. Cool. So time's up. Let me see how many of you got it correct. Okay, so 21 of you, and see. This is what happens. So, even question numbers will be lesser, but not everyone is able to solve this. X, please. How many X? And what happened? This was so easy a question. This was mix of your ninth grade identities as well as trigonometry. So questions will not be that straightforward. There are two approaches to it. Either you can figure out through value. Yes. So if you see X is equal to 90 degrees satisfies this equation. So X equals to 90 degrees. In such question, if you are in a competition, you can try values out. So the standard values will be the solution. There are only yes, four, five standard trigonometric ratios, and mostly it hovers around 0 and 90. So you can immediately check whether it is working like that, or you can factorize yes, as Aniket is mentioning. So what would be the don't need no need to so yeah. So quadratic is one way, but many people haven't done it. So you can always split the middle term. So middle term splitting is the best. Formally, it should be done like that. Sine square x, and you can split the middle term so that it becomes minus sine x plus 2 sine x minus 2 equals 0. Right? So hence you will get sine x common, and this is sine x minus 1. And then from here, 2 common sine x minus 1. And this is equal to 0. Okay, so hence what will you get? Sine x minus 1 into sine x plus 2 is 0. Okay, clearly sine x plus 2 will never be 0. Why? If you see, this is sine x is equal to 1 or sine x is equal to minus 2. Right? So this cannot be, no, can be, can't be negative. Why? It can be negative, but then this is out of bounds. Sine x lies between minus 1 and 1. So this is gone. So hence x sine x is 1. When is sine x 1? When x is 90 degree or pi by 2 radians. X is 90 degree. So hence you put x equals to 90 degree anyways now, you'll get what? So x is 90 degree. So only tan x is not defined in when x is 90 degree. So hence you would be expecting that x equals to 0 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree, and 90 degrees will be given as options. No. Here is the twist. So it will take more time for you to mark it correctly. So these are the questions will be set like that, so that even after you have solved the question, they will still expect you to be very, very careful. Okay, so you could see the difference. There are no direct options. Okay, let's see the leaderboard. All of you got this, those who had asked for the explanation. Okay, very good. So Daksh is okay, very good. Next. Shall we move ahead? Okay, any doubt in the first question? No doubt? Okay, so let's go to next question. Again, please read the question carefully. Please read the question very, very carefully. Okay. Still 1 minute. Minute is there, so you can always try values, or you can go formal way. Enough time is there, you can see and mark actually, but if you are careful. Okay, so some 60 people have already marked it. These are called trigonometric equations. So don't get panicked by the terminology. You already know how to solve equations. We have simply replaced the variables by trigonometric ratios. Nothing else changes. Okay, so here we are done with the second question. And okay, not bad, but then still people are there who are struggling. Okay, very good. So, yep. This was fine, right? You could, you know, so why many people have marked it too. So these are the people who have not seen that I have not put an equality sign here. Okay, so 90 could not be the solution. So many people, how many of you did this mistake? You have counted 90 degrees as well. Right. Now you understand, right? So this is why I keep on saying that. Please read the question carefully. I have purposefully not given this equal to sign here so that you get trapped. And this is what the objective is, that you please learn how to, you know, how to behave in a competition or in a, you know, test like this. So hence, very simple it was actually. If you see, again, 2 sine theta cos theta minus cos theta is 0. Right? So hence cos theta is common, so cos theta common and 2 sin theta minus 1 is 0. So this is factorization you have learned in grade 9, right? So now there are two factors, product is 0, that means either cos theta is 0 or 2 sin theta minus 1 is 0, that means sin theta is half. So if theta is, cos theta is 0, what does theta mean? Theta is 90 degrees, correct? No. And sine theta is half, that means theta is 30 degrees. Okay, but theta 90 was not acceptable. So this is ruled out, only this one. So hence, 1. Got it? No, that will, don't divide by cos q. That means, you know, you got the right answer, but in a different way. Why it is not cos theta, it is not advisable to divide by cos theta, why? Why? Because if cos theta by chance becomes 0, then it is, yeah. So if you are already aware that cos theta cannot be, you know, 0 because it is less than 90 degree, then you are on the right track. Okay, but if you divide, so in an equation, never cancel two factors from LHS and RHS in an equation. Never ever do that. Again, never ever cancel common factors from LHS and RHS. Make sure that they are not 0 because you will miss one root over there if you cancel that. Okay. Yeah. If you know that, then it's fine, Laksh. But, you know, I know most of you will not, you know, pay attention to those minute details. And hence said. Okay. Anyways. So let's go to the leaderboard. So be alert now again. So Hence, alertness phase. Please be alert. Okay, here is the next problem. Okay. Again, read the question carefully. Yeah, it looks like people are more comfortable now. So they have taken only 25 seconds. So many people have responded already. Okay, so last 25 seconds. This was fairly simple if you have done the calculation carefully. Okay, so last 5 seconds now. How many x? Anyone who says x here? Okay, so here is very good. So I can see lots of people have got it correct. Nice. So what was the problem in this question? Okay, never mind. So let me explain it to you. So this was the question. Which of the following is the solution to the equation? 4 cos square theta minus 3. So what is cos square theta? Cos square theta is 3 upon 4. Right? So hence cos theta will be plus minus root 3 by 2. Okay, cos theta is plus minus root 3 by 2. Yeah, so hence if you see 30 degree is what the solution is. So 30 degree cos 30 is root 3 by 2. 390 degree is as good as 30 degree, isn't it? 390 degrees is 360 degrees plus 30 degrees. Okay, so 390 is as good as 30, so this also will satisfy. And theta pi by 6, right? So that is also a radian. Pi by 6 radian is the solution. So all the above can be said as the solution. Is it okay? Fair enough. Since I had not described what theta is, whether it is in degree or radians, so all the three could be. Yes, so those who had put in x, now is it okay? This is for radian. So those who have solved, you know, or gone through the coursework which we have floated, you would have known it by now. And in the test papers of trigonometry also, these type of questions were there. Okay, yes, actually you don't need to, you know, solve all this. So whenever all the above are there, you know, it's a hint enough. Good hint that, you know, so check 30, 390, yes, makes sense. 5 by 6 makes sense. All are same angle. You don't need to solve also. All of them were same angles. So you could have done this way also. Okay. So fair enough. So let's see the leaderboard. Okay. So here is the leaderboard. Next. Very good. No problem. Next. Okay. Okay. Now solve here. Don't get distracted again. You'll have to work it out. Read the question carefully. Come on. Good, good, you are taking time, no worries. Accuracy has to be maintained as 100%. Even if you solve 5-6 questions, make sure that all of them were correct. Or you just let it go. You don't need to mark all the questions. Okay. So last 10 seconds. Last 10 seconds. Okay. So 14 people got it correct. Okay. 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 So hence I think A and D are the same thing. Yeah. So I think there is some, yeah, this was a question anyways. Chalo. So cos square minus sine phi is minus 1/4. So did you solve it or did you put the value? Did you solve it or how many of you solve it? Okay. So hence those who could not solve, right? Cos square phi is 1 minus sine square phi minus sine phi minus 1/4 is 0, right? So this is what you can see it here. So hence it is, if you take everything on the other side, you'll get sine square phi plus sine phi plus 1/4 minus 1 is 0. So sine square phi, again you have to do what? Split the middle term. So no need to put quadratic formula and all that. Minus 3/4 is 0. Okay, so hence it is 4. What happened? Surya saying something. So hence now what will it be? Yeah, so hence 4 sine square phi plus 4 sine phi minus 3 is 0. This is the equation, right? This is the equation. Now split the middle term, so you know how to split it. So 4 sine square phi plus 6 sine phi minus 2 sine phi minus 3 is 0. Okay. Okay. Right. Now what? So 4 sine square phi, right? So you can take common. What will be common? 2 sine square phi and 2 sine phi and 2 sine phi here. Then plus 3. Correct? And minus 2 sine phi plus 3 is 0. Okay, now what? So you can say 2 sine phi plus 3 times, again irrelevant chatting, you have to then leave. I'm telling you, leaderboard is not the final agenda here. Okay, so is that clear? If you are not happy, people are advised to leave, no problem. So stay calm and solve problems. Okay, minus 1 is 0. Okay, so hence sine phi is, what will be sine phi? Minus 3/2. And what will be sine phi again? 1/2. Okay, so which one is correct or both are correct? Which one should I pick? Both are correct or one, only one is correct? Yes, so this is correct. This is correct. Why is this not correct? Because sine phi cannot be less than minus 1. Right, sine phi cannot be less than minus 1. So sine of any angle, sine theta, is always greater than equal to minus 1. Always remember. And also sine theta is less than equal to 1. So with that, this is ruled out. Sine phi is half. So phi will be how much? 30 degrees. Okay. So in this case, tan theta and cos phi, both are correct. Right? Both are correct. Won't this take a lot of time considering the time constraint on the question? No. No, it will not take, because these are the questions which are typical or typically asked in NTNCs and exams like that. So you have to be fast enough, obviously. I am going slow here. The other way of it is, as you know, that it was very obvious. You can start from here to go to this. So you can inspect the options. What all options they are talking about? They are talking about 30 degrees. They are talking about 90 degrees. They are talking about 60 degrees and 30 degrees again. So you have to check three, right? Okay. So when you solve it, see, I am going slow. Why? Because I need to explain to each one of you. Yeah, which one? So Rishita is saying something. Yes, Rishita, once again, is this explanation clear how to solve trigonometric equations? See, I'm doing nothing, guys. Whatever we have learned in previous grades, I'm just utilizing that. Okay, and then, so let's say this kind of a thing is happening in your NTSC exam. Let's say if you are getting two answers correct. So you can use your best judgment to mark it, no problem. And it will be taken care of. Last three steps. Okay. So last, is this clear? So I factorize the given expression. Factorize the given expression to get 2 sine 5 plus 3 and 2 sine 5 minus 1 equals 0. When two factors are product is 0, then each factor could be 0. So hence equating each one of them to be equal to 0, I got sine 5 as minus 3 by 2 and sine 5 is half. But this cannot be acceptable because sine phi cannot be. Sine of any angle is never less than minus 1. Sine value revolves or, you know, oscillates between minus 1 and plus 1. So all the values of sine will be between minus 1 and plus 1. Hence, this is ruled out. So only sine phi is half. So hence, possibly there was an error. And yes, this was the targeted last answer. So we'll skip the leaderboard and go to the next question. All of you are ready with the next question? Okay, ready? Fair enough. Any other doubt in this, guys? Please ask. Any other? All clear? All clear? Yeah. Is it okay? Okay. Next question. Next question is this. Forget that leaderboard. Chalo. This you have to find out the value. What is this value equal to? What is this value equal to? Okay, time's up. So we had, okay, here lots of people got it wrong. Why? Guessed it, I believe, right? How many of you could not get this? No time. Okay, let me see. Let me show you how to deal with such problems. Okay, Deko, first of all, the moment you see minus 3, okay, it is very, you know, if you see, it will take less than 30 seconds to solve this question. The questions will be typically set like that. Okay, so immediately what you do is you need to reciprocate 1 by 1 minus 2 sine a by root 3 plus 2 cos a whole cube, isn't it? And then this is plus root 3. See, how am I solving? Now I'm doing it fast so that you can understand that it can be done within no time. Now, you have to take, you know, what? common denominator. So this will become 1 minus 2 sine a and 1 plus 2 sine a. Dekho, right? Cube. And then plus, and I am ignoring the denominator for the time being because I have a hint that these are simple numbers. The denominator is not going to play much of a role. So see. And then I am doing root 3 plus 2 cos a and cube. Correct? If you see, this is 1 minus a minus b, a plus b form. So this is nothing but 1 minus 4 sine square a whole cubed. And this one is 3 minus 4 cos square a. Right? And now what is, convert any cos or sine into the other thing, right? So hence you can write 1 minus 4 sine square can be written as 1 minus cos square a. Correct? Whole cube plus 3 minus 4 cos square a. Right? Whole cube. Okay? Now see, what is this? If you look carefully, this numerator is 1 minus 4 plus 4 cos square a whole cube plus 3 minus 4 cos square a whole cube. These are, if you see, what is this? 1 minus 4, you have to do like that. Minus 3 here itself. Now, do you see these are additive inverse of each other? They are additive inverse of each other. It will become 0. Over. Problem is over. Within 20-30 seconds, you will be able to solve. Right? So, answer is 0. So, hence, I was explaining how to do it faster. Now I'll explain the process. Right? So, it can be very well done in no time. Okay? Now, coming back to the explanation. Okay, see. That's why I keep number of questions lesser so that everyone can see. Now, what did I do? I just reciprocated because there is minus 3 over here. I think this is not a problem. And then, this is what I got after reciprocation. And then, I did common denominator. So, if you do common denominator, whatever is denominator, forget it. What is numerator? 1 minus 2 sine a cube and 1 plus 2 sine a cube. Okay? And then this one, root 3 minus 2 cos a cube, and for this want of space I'm writing here root 3 plus 2 cos a. Now don't you think these are a minus b, a plus b form? Okay, so if that is so, that's where I started doing that. So hence a minus b, a plus b will give you a square minus b square form plus a square minus b square form. Both are cube, so I'm not touching the cube at all. Now if you look carefully, so what did I do? I converted sine square into 1 minus cos square a here. So I got 1 minus 4 plus 4 cos square a whole cube. Yes, sir.
Who is this? Daksh Singh.
Yeah, Daksh. So what I was saying is, shall I start from the beginning? So once again, reciprocated and then took common denominators taken and then use the identity a square minus b square form. You will get this expression, Daksh, this one at the end of the day. You do it once again and you will get it. 3 minus 4 cos square a whole cube. And if you watch carefully, this is 4 cos square a minus 3 whole cube plus 3 minus 4 cos square a whole cube. Isn't it? If you see, they are additive inverse of each other. They will add up to 0. Why? Because this item can be written as minus 4 cos square a minus 3 whole cube. So this, when added to this, gets you 0. So hence you don't need to even look at the denominator, and the answer was 0. So this is how it will be. Really time consuming and confusing. Yes, life will be like that. They will not give you piece of cake all the time. Okay. So you are, and there will be people, it is in this lot where 22 people could do it. My concern is 6 plus 31 plus 3. You have to work on this through a lot of practicing. So 31 plus 6, 37 plus 3, 40 people, right? So hence, those who have done it, I congratulate you because you were able to solve a complex problem in lesser time. So here is the leaderboard, which I will not be more interested in. I will be interested in who is solving it correctly again and again. So good. Lots of people have done it. That's nice. Okay, next. question again, take do fast, but always keep track of what you're doing. Okay, here is a very simple question. Identity. So hence, solve. Good that people are taking time and solving. That's really nice. Okay. Yes. So how many of you lag time? Oh, very few people got it correct. Oh my God. Why? So was this a guess? Why could you not solve this? Halfway and guessed. How many of you guessed? So don't guess when there is a negative marking, guys. Okay, don't guess when there is a negative marking. Right, it's better not to mark than to, right? Never mind. So now you know what KVPYs are meant, who's meant for KVPYs and other exams. Now you're getting the flavor. Okay, right. So someone has, okay, so Ankur sir is suggesting substitution. That's also fine. But then, you know, many a times, substitution may also lead to two solutions, but never mind. So let's solve it. Okay, and it was again fairly simple. If you would have, I had purposefully removed this bracket, right? So this was what you had to do. Okay, 1 plus tan square a, what is the identity? 1 plus tan square a is bolo, 1 plus tan square a is secant square, right? So secant square a, and then if I would be doing it, I would not be doing step by step in the exam wherein I will be writing common denominator and all that. Immediately I will write this. Tell me if this is correct. Is this correct? So I will not go step by step in this. So hence what will I do then? Secant square is common. Then what is it? 1 plus again tan square a plus 1 by tan square a. Right? So what do I get? I get secant square, again a secant square. So total will be secant 4a, right? Again a secant square from here. So secant square, secant 4 divided by tan square. Period. End of the game. So this is nothing but cos square a by sine square a, which is tan, 1 upon tan that is. And this is secant 4a. So what do I get? I get secant square a times sine square a, right? Right? So hence it is 1 upon cos square a sine square a. That is what I am getting. Correct now. So if you see, this is nothing but 1 upon cos square a can be written as 1 minus sine square a, and game over. Right now. So this is 1 upon sine square a minus sine to the power 4a. This is what, and correct, got it. How much time did we take? Not even 1 minute. Okay, so it's very much possible to solve, right? Very much possible to solve. So now, hence, you know, all those who are aiming at, again, reiterating this funda. This is exactly will be the scene in an exam like KVPY, JEE, NTSC and all that. Taste it now, guys. Practice it. It is a net practice for all of you. Okay? So hence, what did we learn? We learned that it is very much possible. Keep yourself calm. Don't worry about the leaderboard, and XYZ. Doesn't happen. Right? Yes. So please focus on whether you are able to solve the problem here, because it's not a competition between 64, 50, 70 odd people. Lakhs and millions of people will write the exam. Where do you lie? So leaderboard automatically will be taken care of if you are careful and conscious. So next question. Be ready with the pen and paper. Do not panic. It is solvable and very much doable. Okay. Never mind. So here we go for the next question. Start. Do not panic. Complete the question. Even if, let's say, time's up, complete the question. At least you will know what the solution is. Next time you will remember that, hey, this is how it has to be solved. Still 35 seconds left, still can be solved. So I will tell you what is there, you know, when you solve identities, how you have to keep in mind whatever results you get. Normally the tendency of all of you is, what I have observed, you just check whether the answer key matches or not. No one ponders upon any question. That can we just, you know, kind of make this result yours or ours with that. No one does it. Hence, becomes difficult. Now, here is the... Okay, so friends. Okay, so hence here, lots of people have gone wrong. Right? Let me explain it. It was very simple. Again, I will not... So, I remember this. What would I remember? I would remember that this is nothing but... Simple, 1 minus cos theta by 1 plus cos theta. Anyone has any problem in doing this? Right? Anyone? Right? And then same here is, again, 1 plus cos theta by 1 minus cos theta. So I'm not going to write there in the exam that secant is 1 upon cos and take common denominator and all that. No, you have to remember this. When you remember this, then what? It's simple. Again, the common, what you can do is, you can, you know, what have we discussed? If there is a root, go conjugate way. Can we use secant theta minus 1? I need to solve this. Secant theta minus square theta. Yes, you can do that. No problem. You can do that. Yes. So hence, conjugate is the, you know, the key. So if you conjugate it, and I have done it so many times that I know when I'm conjugating. So I'll get 1 minus cos theta on top direct. And here it will be sine theta. Have you done this multiple number of times? Yep, 1 minus cos theta by sine theta, and this one, this will be again 1 plus cos theta by sine theta. If you have done this multiple number of times, and you can see the answer. Yep, anything. So what I'm saying, see, this is by practice, that I know that if under root 1 minus cos theta upon 1 plus cos theta is given, after conjugation, you get under root 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by 1 minus cos square theta, which is 1 minus cos theta divided by sine theta. So if you remember this directly, so you'll save time. So always remember, under root 1 minus cos theta upon 1 plus cos theta is 1 minus cos theta by sine theta. So that will help you. And then after this no-brainer, so cos theta will go only 2 upon sine theta. So hence, 2 cosecant theta, right? Whichever way, Yeah, how many got it correct? Anyways, we are time is running out. Never mind. Good. Let's see the leaderboard. Very good. Keep it up. So this is the next. Okay, Ankur sir, you are taking one position. That's not correct. You're taking one position of these people. Anyways, next question, guys. Start. If sine square theta plus sine theta is 1, then cos to the power 8 theta plus 2 cos 6 theta plus cos 4 theta is equal to. No problem, Aniket. Learn, yaar. Learning is important. Winning or losing is not important here. We will talk about winning and losing when we get to that point. Don't worry. Seekho. Practice in your own paper and pen. Take your time. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Yes, go. So, how many? Oh my God. So, lots of people have got it correct. How many X? How many could not solve it? Tell me. X. Yeah, lot of you have not been able to. No worries, guys. See. So, okay, here is the explanation. I have partly solved it so that it saves time. So, what you can do is, sine theta is 1 minus sine square theta from the equation C. So, it is cos square theta. So, what do I get? Sine theta is cos square theta. This is the given part of it. Okay. Not really. You don't need to square and all. So, you know, you can get it directly from here. So, sine theta is cos square theta. Now, you know, deploy this here. So, you'll get this equation. Sine to the power 4 theta plus 2 sine cube theta plus sine square theta. And take sine square common. You'll get sine theta plus 1 whole square. This is what it is. Okay? So, this is what it will get reduced to. Now, what you can do? What can you do? You can say, so what will you do? You will do this, that sine square theta can be written as 1 minus, did I get something wrong? Okay, no. So did I get something wrong here? Sine to the power 4 theta plus 2 sine cube theta plus sine square is common. Sine square theta plus, yes, it's correct, right? No. So, okay, fair enough. Now, sine square theta was 1 minus sine theta. See, from top, 1 minus sine theta. Okay, and so I replace this sine square theta from this. So sine square theta is 1 minus sine theta, right? And this is 1 plus sine theta whole square. Correct? Then if you see, 1 minus sine theta is equal to 1 plus sine theta and 1 plus sine theta. This is the final expression. And now I'll use this. What is this? 1 minus sine square theta. So I'm writing here 1 minus sine square theta times 1 plus sine theta. This is what is left. Now 1 minus sine square theta is again sine theta, guys. See, 1 minus sine square theta is sine theta from here. So sine theta, and this is 1 plus sine theta. So what is it? Open it up, you'll get sine theta plus sine square theta. And what is sine theta plus sine square theta? It's given to be equal to 1. So answer is 1. Right? Is that okay? So you have to do. Understood? The explanation is understood? Explain again. Okay, no problem. See, Okay, so what I did was, okay, let me explain with this color. Yeah, so sine theta is cos square theta Purav, right? From this equation, given equation, because you can write this as 1 minus sine square theta is equal to sine theta if you rearrange it. So 1 minus sine square is cos square, so cos square theta is sine theta. Remember this. So 1 cos square theta is sine theta from here, and then you just deploy simply code. Why you lost the, just a minute, don't worry, someone can help Varsha with code. Yeah, so what is the expression? So cos 8 is cos square to the power 4 theta, isn't it? Like that. So cos square theta is sine theta, so this will become simply sine 4 theta. Okay, sine 4 theta, sine square theta, sorry, whichever, Aditi, if you found it easier, no problem. Sine 4 theta plus 2 sine cube theta plus sine square theta, right? This is what the expression would be reduced to. And then take sine square theta common. So what is left? Sine square theta plus 2 sine theta plus 1. And what is it? A plus B whole square. So sine square theta into sine theta plus 1 whole square. That's it. And then what did I do? Again, I deployed sine square theta from the equation. What is sine square theta from the given relation? It is 1 minus sine theta. So I ended up doing like that. Whatever came in my mind immediately, because I have to save time, right? So this is what I got. Sine square theta is replaced by 1 minus sine theta. And then I took 1 plus sine theta from it, borrowed from here. So it becomes 1 minus sine square theta. And this becomes 1 plus sine theta. And this square term is gone because I borrowed. And then 1 minus sine square theta is, or again, or rather 1 plus, 1 minus sine square theta. Did I do that? Yeah. Correct? Yeah. So 1 minus sine square theta, I again wrote it from here. So if you see 1 minus sine square theta, if you see 1 minus sine square theta is sine theta. So I simply wrote this as sine theta and then multiplied whatever was left. So I got sine theta plus sine square theta. Now sine theta plus sine square theta was given to be equal to 1. I ended up getting the same thing. So 1. Okay, clear? We still have 4 questions left, guys. Okay, if still not clear, I would suggest just go through the recording once again. Now, diagrams will be required. So be ready. Application of trigonometry questions are to follow. And I will show you how to do it fast. Very fast. Okay. Next. Quickly draw the diagram as fast as you can. Label it and then use the information of 45 degrees. Hint. Still people have marked. Guesswork. So this time I have to identify who all are guessing. Maybe, yes, Aniket, maybe. Okay, still solving. Very simple. If you know, if you draw the diagram quickly, it will be very, very simple. 3, 2, 1. Not everyone could answer it. No problem. So that means you are struggling. More practice is required. Answer is A, that's correct, and many of you have got it wrong also. Now let me check, tell you how to quickly draw the diagram and solve it. So I've already drawn it, but for your understanding, let me start from fresh. So, yeah. So the moment I see this, I will, a man is standing on the deck of a ship which is 10 meter above water level for 10. Then he observes the angle of elevation of a top of a hill. So there's a hill. Then angle of elevation 45. So join. So this is 45. Put it X. So this is X. The angle of depression of the base of the hill. So okay, fair enough. Depression. So this is 30. Okay. This is 10. So this is 10. Close. Kadam. Tan 30. Don't even write tan 30. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. Remember it. So it is 10 upon X. So X you got. X is 10 root 3. X is 10 root 3. What is that? Calculate distance of the hill from the ship and the height of the hill. So X is known. So now you can rule out. X is 10 root 3, 17 point something, right? So only one option is there, done. So you can solve so quickly, right? And now I explain how to solve it methodically. Is this method clear to everyone? How did I solve quickly within no time? So that's how you have to do. Quickly draw a diagram. And it could be rough also. Don't worry about the neatness over there in the exam. In such kind of exams, and then quickly see, wait a minute. Yeah, so I quickly drew the diagram, and then if it was 45 degree, I use this the moment it is 45 degree. Okay, once again, so this is how it is to be done. See. Man is standing on the deck of a ship which is 10 meter above water level. So first line, 10 meter, write it like that. He observes the angle of elevation of the top of a hill. So that means there is another hill like that and top of a hill. So this is the angle of elevation which is given to be equal to 45 degree. In a right angle triangle, the moment anything is 45 degree, the other has to be 45. So it's an isosceles triangle. This is done. Now angle of depression of the foot is 30 degrees. It's given, right? Angle of depression of the base of the hill is 30 degree. Calculate the distance of the hill. So you have to find out X first and then 10 plus X. You have to find X and 10 plus X. What is X? So if you see this diagram, 10 upon X is tan 30 in this triangle. You have to look very fast. 10 by X, 1 by root 3. Remember the values. Don't really forget that and then gone. If you forget it, gone. So X is 10 root 3. Done? X is 10 root 3 and that is first thing. So hence check the option there itself. So 10 root 3 is root 3 is 1.73. So 10 times it 17.32. So one is one up. The distance of the hill has to be 17.32. Only one option is there which is having. And you can see even if you have to calculate the height of the hill, it is 10 more than X. So see 27.3. So hence A. Done. Okay. That's how we have to do it. Next also, we are going to deal with similar type of question. Draw diagram quickly and keep in mind the data which is given. Very good. Chalo. Next question is here on your screen. Come on guys, take your time. Some time will be lost in reading. Keep track of 45 degrees. The moment elevation 30 degrees. So you remember the tan values. Tan is only required. And I have given you 2 minutes for this, so don't worry. 2 minutes are there. 2 minutes is good enough to solve this. Okay. How many could get it? Let me see now. Oh. Still a lot of people are making mistakes then. Yeah, or you are guessing. Right? So quickly see how to. Yes, I will explain. Don't worry. See, now observe all of you. Don't write X. I know I have to explain. Don't worry, I'm explaining. Listen to what I'm saying. Okay? Pay attention to the way I will be reading the question and then drawing the diagram quickly and then jumping on how to. Always remember in height and distance, majorly it is sine and tan, or tan only most of the time. And see how I'm reading and solving simultaneously. See, this is the question. Amit is standing on the ground. So quickly draw a ground and flying a kite with 100 meter of string. So this is 100 meter at a 30 degree angle. Done. Right 100. Then another boy, Nitin, is standing on the roof of a 10 meter high building, but you have to read it. And is flying his kite at an elevation of 45 degree. Very good. So keep that in mind. So there will be a guy who is flying like that, 45 degrees. So keep in mind only. Both Amit and Nitin are on the opposite side. That is what I was looking for. So hence, if this is a kite, this person is here at 10 meter height right now. And he is flying kite like that. So this is the kite. Both are together. Find the length of the string that the second boy must have so that the two kites meet. So let's say this is L. Diagram done quickly. And then your do the needful, right? So what is 45 degree, guys? This is 45. Brilliant. If this is 45, you know this is L by root 2. This is L by root 2. This has to be in your mind. L sine theta, L cos theta, right? If that is there, then what? This is 10. Okay. Then what? You have to find out. What do you need to find out? L only. So L by root 2. Yeah. So now if you see 100 sine 30. So this length is 100 sine 30 is equal to L by root 2 plus 10. Okay, this is the equation I got and that's it. Sine 30 is half, so 100 becomes 50. 50 is L by root 2 plus 10. So 40 is L by root 2. So L is 40 root 2. Done. Answer is 40 root 2 meters. A. Yeah, so hence this is how. How much time did we take? No time. So almost like 30 seconds maximum, 30 to 45 seconds, good enough time to solve such problems. There will be definitely 2 to 3 problems of application of trigonometry, at least in NTSC, and then one step ahead in KVPY definitely. So hence this was very simple question. Again, what did we do? Read the question very fast without losing the, so you know the usual idea is you keep circling the data also, it's very very important at times. So mining the data, right? So immediately I saw 100 meter, okay, length of kite. So always keep this in mind. Length of kite, that means it is hypotenuse we are talking about. String, 30 degrees is the angle of elevation. Then another boy, Nitin, standing on the roof, 10 meter high. So this is 10 meter from 45. The moment it was 45, automatically it was L by root 2 which came in my mind. I deployed it immediately without going into that. So all this is part of the game. So this you will not be able to do if you don't solve the problems which you do regularly in your assignments without consciousness, right? So hence you have to see that if 45 degrees is there, if L is the hypotenuse, the other two sides will have to be L by root 2. So I saved my time over there. And then the moment I got L by root 2 and I got 10, and if I know the hypotenuse, I know the perpendicular is sine theta times the hypotenuse. So I use that. Otherwise, normally people would have done sine 30 degree is equal to L by root 2 plus 10 by 100. This also you could have done, no problem. And then solve it for L, you get 40 root 2. Clear, fast and effective. Good, understood? Next. This all is not, so don't think that I have, you know, mastered it over, you know, few days. It takes a lot of time and lots of repetition to achieve this. So hence we keep on, you know, emphasizing on do as many questions as possible and learn from the questions also. Don't only just remember there is theory, there is problem. Okay, next. Similar, very easy, very, very easy. So hence, these type of problems would have been discussed. Okay. Over. Let me see how many of you got it. Okay. Good number of people, but still not many people could not. Again, see the pace. How do I do and how do I? So, angle of elevation of a cloud from a point h meters above, oh, lake is Q, that is theta actually. I hope this has not disturbed you. So, I should have told you that. Oh, no, this is in my this thing. In your question, it was theta only, right? In your question, it was theta only because I had corrected it. Yes, so theta and h meters above a lake is right theta. So hence, the angle of elevation of a cloud. So this is cloud and it is elevated from a point h meters above the lake. So this is lake h theta, right? And the lake is on the ground, obviously. Oh, then I have to draw. Reflection of the lake is 45 degrees. So let's say this is the reflection and this is 45 degrees. Clear? Clear? Diagram is clear. So this is the lake ground. Ground. I'm going slow now this time. And H is there. So let this be H. And let's say you are finding capital H. Always keep the variable which you want like that. Okay, H. And then here it is. This is also H. Sorry, it is actually playing with two colors, so hence let me use this. Yeah, so this is also H because reflection has to be, you would have studied in physics, reflection, you know, image distance is equal to object distance. Now over, so 45 degree actually helps a lot. Why? Because if this is X, this is X, then X is this is capital, this one is H. So don't you think I can write X is equal to H plus H? Why? Isosceles triangle. So this solves a lot of purpose. And then what is this length? H minus small h. Correct? So h minus small h divided by x. Now divided by x is equal to tan theta. Right? Now instead of this, I can write x as h plus h tan theta. Now you just need to solve this one. So quickly solve h minus h is equal to h tan theta plus small h tan theta, and you have to find out capital H, right? So keep that in mind. So capital H here, so 1 minus tan theta is equal to h common from here, and this is 1 plus tan theta. So my dear friend, h will be small h times 1 plus tan theta. Actually, you don't need to write till this step. The moment you see the previous step, your mind should know that this is the hypotenuse is not x. No, this, I have not treated that as, I have treated this is a rectangle, right? So this is going in my mind. So this is x. So this is also x. Okay. Yep. So hence the option is this. So hence I was saying that you don't need to go to this level here itself. Many people would see this and mark the correct answer. So what was this? 1 plus 1 minus tan theta by 1 plus tan theta, this one. Or did I get the other way around? I found out something, some other H, I think. What was the question? The height of the cloud. Capital H only I had to find out, no? So H 1 minus tan theta is equal to okay, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Did I do some wrong calculation or something? I messed it up, maybe. So x is h plus h. Angle of depression was 45 degrees. Yes. So h plus h is x. That's fine. So h minus h divided by x is tan theta. So x is h plus h. So h plus h tan theta. That's fine. Yeah, so hence h and 1 minus tan theta is equal to 1 plus tan theta. Yes, so it should be 1 plus tan theta by 1 minus tan theta. What is the correct answer? Or did I mess somewhere up? I don't know. Wait a minute. Just let me check once again. H minus h 1 x is h plus h is x, so h minus h naught, h minus h is 1 plus h tan theta plus h tan theta, so h capital H 1 minus tan theta. Yeah, it's correct. Why it is coming like that? One plus tan theta capital is H is 1 plus tan theta by 1 minus tan theta, it should come. Correct? H meters, yes. So I think the answer, B is correct, no? A is correct. Guys, sorry. A is correct. But only 4 people had marked it. That is surprising. Only 4 people marked that. Or we are doing something wrong here. I think we are only 4 people. Anyways, let's see. Never mind. Let's go to the next question. The final one. Answer is A. Sorry. So, not... Oh, a few people have marked it. Oh, but these people are wrong. So, Shobita, Eden, Momita, Surya, you are wrong. Sorry. Never mind. Let's go to the last question. Okay, so in last 15 seconds for all. Okay, so here is the final tally. Oh. Cool, so people have got. Okay, so again, let me explain this quickly. Angle of depressions of the top and bottom of 10 meter tall building from the top of a multi-storied building, right? And so hence this is multi-storied building. Okay, angle of depression of the top and bottom of 10 meter tall. So this is multi-storied building and this is the another building which is 10 meter tall. And they're saying depression, right? Angle of depression. So this is quickly, this is 30 degree. Obviously it cannot be 60. This is 60. So that's how I quickly draw the diagram. So you know that these are alternate interior angles, so you can mark it directly 60 and this is 30. Okay, this is 60 and 30. Actually this was given as 60 degree. Fair enough. Now 10 is given, so hence you have to find out what? Two things. Find the height of the multi-storied building. So many a times this itself will give you, but then they are smart, they are giving two options with the same thing. So hence we have to be little, you know, cautious. So h is the total height, this is 10, then definitely this is h minus 10, this portion is h minus 10. Okay, now let it be x, immediately take the, you know, and then what, then solve h minus 10 by x. is tan 30. Don't write tan 30 and all. Write value directly. Then second triangle H upon X is tan 60 is root 3. So you know now H directly root 3X or X directly. What was to be found out? Oh, both H and X are known. Never mind. So hence if you divide both of them, these two equation, what will you get? H minus 10 by H, X gets cancelled, is 1 by 3. Why? Because 1 by root 3 divided by root 3 is 1 by root 3 times root 3 in the denominator. So 1 by 3. So fast you have to do it. So this is 3H minus 30 is equal to H. So 2H is equal to 30. So H is 15. H is 15. So hence, two options B and C are correct. Which one? So now you have to kind of distance between. So X also you have to find out. So X is H by root 3. So that is 15 by root 3 meters. So which one? 15 by root 3? Yeah, so 15 by root 3 is 5 root 3 meters. Isn't it? Rationalize quickly. You can do it mentally also. So 5 root 3. So which one is correct? C. Yeah. Okay. Is it understood? Did you understand? So we are not C. Well, I have C. Don't go by my speed and all. So I have been doing this all this my life. That's not the agenda. Agenda is, are you minutely observing? So what are the learnings of the day? Learnings of the day is whenever you're solving problems also, there will be lots of insights generated. Lots of insights. For example, if you see, I'm very comfortable in dividing. Many people will be taking a lot of time. Then I'm very comfortable in the values, right? So tan 30, I know in the back of my this thing, that this is 1 by root 3, tan 60, root 3. So you have to be very, very thorough. It happens only when you do multiple number of times and then carefully, you know, so I am not writing steps like 3 into H minus 10 is equal to H into 1 and all that. That will eat up a lot of time. So you have to learn how to do it. X, how is X is X plus H? Where? Question number 11. Where? How is X is equal to 45 degrees it was given, no? Adit, so this is X. So this triangle is isosceles, right? So if this height is H, if this height is H and this is capital H, so small h plus capital H will be X. Okay. Yeah. So you don't need to do sine and cos 45, Mumita. 45 degrees. Do not complicate unnecessarily. The moment 45, water, mouth watering. The moment I see 45 degree in the question, the first thing which strikes my mind is the triangle is isosceles. So this is a trait which we have developed over a period of time. So you have to develop the same thing. At the moment you see 45, oh, equal. The moment you see 60, 360 degrees, that means, oh, sides are equal, equilateral triangle. So hence all of that has to flash in your mind like the moment you read it. And hence it saves time. It happens not because you are extraordinarily intelligent or something. No. It happens when you do similar type of problems n number of times. And hence repetition, repetition, repetition. I keep shouting. I keep encouraging all of you that solve many, many questions. Okay. And methodically that is. So all this will take some time for you to develop. Don't worry. So we solved 12 questions only, but the learnings are immense. Learnings are point number one, read the question carefully. Many of you lost the question number two above because you didn't see the less than equal to sign. This one. So reading question saves your, you know, effort. Read question carefully. Be, you know, the other thing like canceling and all that is not, allowed all the time. Then many a times through angles itself, you can figure out that you need not solve this and your answer was all the above in this case. This is another trick. Then in this one, what did we learn? You have to, yeah, this one, actually there was a problem here. So value putting is also helping. This one, I didn't care about denominator. Numerator itself served the purpose. You don't need to panic in this kind of question. Next one, all identities, quick and fast. Practice, period, no big deal. Then here, remembering that secant theta minus 1 can be expressed as 1 minus cos theta and 1 plus cos theta like that. And conjugate kafanda, when you are solving it, you remember these results. Remember, remembering is not a bad thing. So hence, if you remember, it saves time. Okay. Now this one, yes, little complicated, little tricky, but then if you stay calm, it will be done, right? So we have multiple ways people solved it, multiple approaches. That's really fine. That's great. Here, drawing is very essential. Drawing is very essential. Why? Because it saves a lot of effort in terms of equations and all that. So always in height and distance problems or any application problems, draw diagrams quickly. It gives a lot of clarity to your mind, and look at the same time on the options. Look, have a look on the options. Maybe the options are helping you to solve. Okay, so hence be mindful of that as well. Correct? Okay, now, and don't fear with, you know, and the other thing was that 45 degrees, the moment I saw 45, X and X should be fast, lightning fast, like that. Okay, and again, read the question, note the data, wait for, you know, some other, I was just waiting for whether the people were on the same side or the opposite. Okay, opposite sides. And the moment I saw opposite, I jumped over my seat and then drew the diagram. I was kind of, while I was doing it, I was always having this kind of a diagram in my mind. So this was going on. So it could be either like that or like that. So hence, the moment I saw opposite, I jumped on that. Okay. Then here, reflection problem. So physics ka concept is also employed over and above that. 45 degree, again, same isosceles triangle. Drawing neat diagrams will help. And always remember in exams like all these, you know, NTSC and all, many a times they will give you very less amount of stationery. So you have to learn the art of doing it, you know, in a very small amount of space over and over again. So in one sheet, there will be around 6 to, you know, so now though it's online, so it's not a problem, but then stationery could be an issue. And even if they give you an enormous amount of stationery, that's not a good, you know, way of, because then you will be all over the place. So you have to manage it in a very small amount of space. So all this comes through practice, my dear friend, and the whole intention of this centum hour and other things is that you get enough practice, enough sense of problem solving. Leaderboard and all that is okay, fair enough. You get some position here and there. You know, just take it with a pinch of, you know, what do you say? You know, don't really take it very seriously. It's good that you are, you know, it gives you a good benchmark. So hence, oh wow. So we have Suman and who else? So, okay, no. Shobita from INR. Wonderful. Very good, Shobita. Keep it up. Shobita is, so whether this is actually true or not, doesn't matter. Let's celebrate Shobita's success. Followed by Pranav, Shreyas, all top 10, or for that matter, anyone who had participated. You really did a good job, guys. Keep an eye on problem solving. That's the whole intention. Okay? Yeah. Anyone wants to say something? Yeah, someone was saying something. Okay, see you guys. So all of you keep it up. And then next week, as I have promised, no problem. Our target is to restrict it to 9 only, Aryan. So we will try and see. You know, explanation takes a lot of time. Don't worry. And next week, as we have suggested, we will do social science quiz. So be ready, guys, for the next year, next week's geography quiz. Okay. Bye-bye. Take care. Good night.